Do you remember when your parents or your grandparents used to tell you to save the money and see it grow, see it double in one day, 5 days, maybe 10 months to help you build that habit of saving? I don't think many of us followed through, but it is always exciting to know when our money will double. And there's an equation for that. It's logarithmic 2 with the base of 10 divided by logarithm of 1 plus your interest rate with the base 10 as well. I don't know about you, but I am definitely not carrying around my log tables or my logarithmic calculators around most of the times. And this is where the rule of 72 really helps. The rule of 72 essentially gives you an approximation of how fast your money will double. So all you need to do is divide 72 by the interest rate that you are getting on an investment product, and you will have the amount of time that it will take for your money to double. For example, 72 divided by if you are getting 8% returns on the stock market will take you 9 years to double your money. Similarly, if you are looking at a 7% interest, your money will take roughly 10.2, 10.3 years to double. But how accurate is the rule of 72? The rule of 72 works really well between the interest rates of 6 to 10%. So if your interest rate was 6%, you divide 72 by 6 and you have 12 years. Similarly, if you have an interest rate of 10%, you divide 72 by 10 and you get to about 7.2 years, which is how long it'll take for you to double your money. But when you deviate more than 3% on either side of 8%, you might want to adjust 72 on either side by 1. Let me explain. So if your interest rate is 5%, which is 3 points away from 8%, you would subtract 1 from 72, so that makes it 71, and divide 71 by 5. Similarly, if your interest rate is 12%, it's 4 away from 8, you would add 1 to 72. So your number of years will be approximately 73 divided by 12. But why is the rule of 72 interesting? I think the rule of 72 is really interesting because it dwells on the compound interest, which is something that I've talked about in a greater detail in this video over here. If you want, go check that out after you've seen this. But essentially, what it means is that you are better off choosing an investment that gives you higher returns than one that gives you lower returns. Case in point, your cash ISA or your cash savings accounts versus your stocks and shares portfolios. Your stocks and shares portfolio will have a higher return than the cash in your bank, which sometimes have interest rates as low as 1 or 2%, which don't even beat inflation. Whereas your stocks and shares portfolio will likely return you 7-8% year on year. What you also want to be considering is inflation. So the 7% or 8% stock market growth that I generally talk about on this channel is inflation adjusted. S&P 500 historically over the last few decades has yielded over 10% year on year. Inflation had been hovering around 2% for most of those decades. However, if we are settling down into a higher inflation regime, then you might want to consider that while you are doing your math. So what I would suggest is divide 72 with the difference between your interest rate and the rate of expected inflation. This is your own expectation of inflation numbers, because as we all know, inflation changes every year, every month even, right? But let me sidetrack here for a second and talk to inflation. What is inflation? Inflation is essentially the rate at which prices rise. It is not how much prices rise, it is the speed at which prices rise. So essentially, what used to cost you $1 before costs you $5 now, and that is essentially because of inflation. So very likely that even if you save $100K this year and your rate of interest is 2% and your inflation is 3%, you actually will be losing money, not getting money, which is why I think it's really useful to consider inflation into your compound interest calculation. But it's not only money that we can use the rule of 72 for. You can use the rule of 72 to see when the money that you hold in the bank will essentially halve, which is if you divided 72 by the rate of inflation, then you'll know that your money will halve in X many years. It's not only money. I could also use the rule of 72 for other things. For example, my YouTube channel. Say, for example, I set the goal of doubling my YouTube subscribers in 6 months' time. What I would do is divide 72 by 6, which would mean that I would need to grow month on month 12%. Currently, I'm growing at 2% per month because you folks are not subscribing. 80% of the people who look at this channel don't subscribe. So do me a favor, if you enjoyed this video and if you found it useful, do consider subscribing. It does help us out a lot. And if you enjoyed this, you definitely will enjoy these other videos that I'll link up here. And I'll see you the next time. Bye.